Now that we're logged into the browser application, let's spend a few minutes just getting ourselves familiar with general navigation. So first and foremost, if you look up the top in the banner bar, you'll see a little magnifying glass, and that gives you the ability to search across multiple areas of the application. So if you put in a person's name, you'll see if they're associated to a lead, you'll see their contact record, maybe some opportunities that they're associated with. It just allows you to get at information quicker without actually having to go to a list and doing a search or a filtered search from there. Next, we have this concept of task flows, and you can actually build out task flows that allow you to, you know, kind of create some repetitive component to an individual task that you may have in the system. So for example, you know, after you have a meeting, why don't you go ahead and update your appointment, update all of the meeting notes, update, you know, who attended and what was discussed, ultimately creating a real quick trip report. So this task flows allows you to take things that your sales organization does on a regular basis, streamline it in a little mini application, and basically have them walk through a couple of quick questions to update information that you would need to have updated as part of your management process. We have the assistant feature, which is really a great tool that allows you to stay on top of all of the notifications that are inside the system, like a new lead was assigned to you, or you haven't responded to an opportunity in a few days. You know, think of it as a personal assistant, if you will, for your sales organization that's going to service up information and insights that's important to them and allow them to be more productive in their job. You also have this concept for quick create. So you can quickly create a contact record. You can quickly create an opportunity if you wanted to on the fly without having to do too much work and be presented with a full screen of blank information. What quick create does is it creates a very small, lightweight form on the right-hand side of the page that allows you to fill in information to create a record easily. And then, you know, last thing I want to talk about from a navigation perspective on the top bar is this concept of advanced find. And this is really where you're going to create views of information that will help drive dashboards and help drive list views inside the system. This is really the ad hoc querying tool that 99% of the reporting and visibility that you're looking to get will be achieved through. It's very user-friendly, very easy to use, and end users will have access to this information, eliminating the need to actually have an individual report writer. Now, if I click over here on the sitemap and kind of open it up, you can see all the different areas that are available to you within the environment. We're going to hone in on a few. There's dashboards. This is where I'm going to be able to see all my dashboard-related information, and I'll come back to that in a moment. I can see a list of all of the activities that are associated to me by clicking on activities, and these show me all of my activities that are associated to me, and they can have start dates and due dates, so you can actually fill that information in. I can see a list of accounts that are inside the system, and you can actually filter between multiple types of views. So if I want to just look at my active accounts, so accounts that may be associated to me, I can see a list of that specifically. So there's multiple list views inside an entity for you to go ahead and visualize information. Contacts is going to give you a similar view to accounts, and opportunities is going to give you a similar view to that as well. They're just giving you a list of information. Now, I will click on opportunities and show you that we can also present the information in a Kanban view that allows you to basically see everything in a graphical representation based off of the sales process that you're in. So this Kanban allows me to see, you know, here's all the deals that exist in this particular pipeline phase with the dollar amount, and then I can drill into any one of these that I want to. You also have the ability to kind of drag and drop them and move them from area to area to update the pipeline. And if I choose I don't want to see it in a Kanban view and I'd rather just see it in a grid view, you can quickly make that change to see the information in that fashion. So real easy to be able to navigate from area to area within the solution. So now I want to spend a little bit of time talking to you about dashboarding and what we can do from a dashboarding perspective. So you can have multiple dashboards available to you inside the environment. So if I just switch to an executive dashboard, and I want to be able to look at what's going on from my team's perspective. You know, what does our sales pipeline look like? Who are some of our top customers? You know, where are leads coming from? You know, what's the priority level based off of the types of activities that are going on? You know, and what does revenue look like on a monthly basis so I can start to understand that information? So these aren't just necessarily static dashboards where I can visualize information. I actually have the ability to, you know, view the underlining records that sit within that. So for example, if I go ahead and open this up, and I'm just going to quickly change my view to read-only list, and I want to laser focus in on this purple section of the pipeline phase, which is what we call our propose phase, to see the deals that are there and what's expected of those deals. So we've got three deals that are in that phase of the pipeline, and I can now click on any one of these opportunity names and drill right into the opportunity record, or I can drill right into the account record if I wanted to as well. So really, at a top level, I have the ability to, you know, see a graphical representation of information based off of multiple entities like opportunities, leads, activities, and revenue. And I have the ability to drill into those records to see the underlining detail of a segment of that particular, chart visualization. And then I have the ability to drill right into that record if I wanted to do so. So really great way for you to get at all of that necessary information. To take that a step further, you know, if this particular view is something that I like to look at on a regular basis, I can go ahead and certainly view those records. But one of the other things that we can do here as well is I have the ability to export this information into Excel. And I can do it in a couple of different fashions. I can do it from a static worksheet, which basically takes a Polaroid image of what we're looking at here. I've got 102 records and puts them into an Excel sheet that I can interact with. Or I can do a dynamic worksheet or even a dynamic pivot table that will allow me to kind of, you know, if you understand pivot tables and I can set filters and look at the information in a different fashion, I've got that capability. But by using the word dynamic, what it does is it actually creates a link back to this particular view inside the system. So when I'm in Excel, I have to just simply click on refresh from data, and it'll go out and grab the latest and greatest data from this view and update it for me in Excel. So an extremely tight integration from, you know, Microsoft Office to, you know, the Dynamics environment. And then not only that, I have the ability to import information. So if I've got a list of leads or a list of opportunities that I've gotten from a trade show or an event or maybe a road trip that I recently went on where I was visiting, you know, customers and prospects, I can go ahead and import that information as well. You'll be presented with a template that you could use to populate the data that you want to enter. And then you can just go ahead and quickly click on import and it'll consume that information inside the environment. Now, one of the other great things is there's also this concept of a bit more of an advanced dashboard. And if I click on open dashboards, this brings me to a really detailed view of all of the opportunity dashboards that I as a sales rep or I as a sales manager have visibility into. So think of those Excel spreadsheets that you're getting and you're having your sales team update on a regular basis, and you're bringing that information in and you're trying to consolidate to understand where that information is coming from. Well, now I've got it all in a simple dashboard and I can drill in on that and I can actually show some unique visualizations. So what we're looking at from this perspective is just a very basic dashboard of my opportunities, and I can see the ones that I'm working on, the open opportunities that are out there, the ones that we've recently closed, and then just a list of all of the opportunities that may be out there that the entire organization is working on that I have, you know, the ability to see. If I turn on the visualization, it's going to allow me to start to visualize this information a bit differently. So for example, I want to look very specifically at the four deals that represent the develop phase of our pipeline that are working on. So if I go ahead and click on that, I can actually now see that information and see where it sits within the pipeline. So there are four deals that are out there that sit within this subsegment of the pipeline. Two of them belong to me. You know, one of them is closed, and there are three that remain open that I can interact with. So this is showing me a really great way to get at an opportunity view, add some filters, and then drill down to the subset of records that may lie underneath all of that. So really the goal here is to provide your sales organization with a tool that gives them the ability to access information, access dashboards, access data real quickly at your fingertips in order to, you know, keep management up to date. And ideally here, from a management perspective, you're eliminating the need to, you know, ask for updates from Excel spreadsheets, from your sales team, or get them on the phone to understand, you know, really what are they working on this week and what's important. Use the system here to, you know, capture that information at a top level and then report on it and then graphically have the ability to drill down into that unique record to see exactly what's going on. So next, we're going to spend a little bit of time diving into some generic account management to understand, you know, how account structures are organized and really how we can get a nice 360-degree view of all of the interactions that are related to a customer transaction.